Welcome back to Electron Mind. Yes, we'll be talking about the relationship between energy and momentum. Firstly, what's energy? Energy is said to be the weight of doing work, because for you to be able to do work, there's a word energy applied to it. That's why we're talking about the form of energy that we have. We have the kinetic energy and the potential energy. They are the form of what those are the mechanical of energy. That is using kinetic energy, KE, kinetic energy, which is KE, to be equal to half 1 over 2 mv squared. So we have KE to be equal to 1 all over 2 mv squared, because that first equation 1. Now, what's a momentum? A momentum is a product of mass times change in what? Velocity. A momentum is what? Is a product of mass times change in velocity. So you can say that momentum P is equal to mass times velocity. That is, P will give us mv equation 2. P will give us mv. Now, from this equation, we can able to derive the relationship between the energy and the momentum. How do we do this? This is what we do. You square both sides. When we square both sides, we'll be having p squared, m squared, v squared for momentum. Let's call this equation 3. From this equation, we can make velocity. This is the formula. We have velocity v squared to give us p squared all over m squared. From this equation, we say that kinetic energy equal to half mv squared. So we substitute v squared into equation 1, equation asterisk. If v squared is given on this, we'll be having KE to be given us 1 all over 2 m times p squared all over m squared. M cancel out m. Kinetic energy KE will be equal to half p squared all over m squared. That is, E is 1 all over 2 p squared over m squared all over m. So we have p squared all over 2m. Energy is equal to 2p squared all over 2m. From this relation, we can talk about the relationship between what? Energy and momentum.